Fuck.
The following program is intended for mature audiences.
Welcome
to Rizzo's channel on YouTube, bro. It's been a while since I used a bike pump. Jesus. I got an exercise ball that I use to stretch my legs out. And holy shit. It's like jerking up with both hands at the same time.
When I want to be naughty.
Oh shit, that's not good. But it really is though. It really is though. I was gonna stop myself midway through saying it, and I'm like, fuck it, I'm committed. If you're, I don't know, I don't think my demographic is under the age of 18, so I think I'm all right. But if you happen to be under the age of 18, I'm sorry, Mom.
Not my chin, not my problem. That's what I say.
I try to keep it clean for the kiddies. She doesn't work like that all of the time. And, hold on, I see y'all, man. I'll get to you in a second.
Of course!
For now.
What are you selling?
Podcast for free called Trainwreck, SoundCloud, iTunes, Spotify, Radio Public. I have a playlist on YouTube. All 7 episodes, 8 is in the vault, ready to go on Friday. I think that's when I was supposed to put it out. So, dude told me, when I did Sorceress, I don't remember, that I need to do window pane. Some of you already know what I'm talking about. Others may not. Ugh.
No.
Opeth, I don't know why I couldn't get it out. Oh shit. Holy shit. Okay. That's a bouncy bass line. Wait, I am recording, right? Okay. Oh yeah, I forgot they like to do long intros. Oh, this one's over a mil. A million. Hold on, man. Where's the... Bro. You give me 1,000 links, dude, and you tell me this is a lyrics video with no fucking lyrics in it. You fuck. You're lucky I don't have my Pacino soundboard up. Well, hold on.
Disappears and returns again. Counting hours, searching the night.
Cry to me. How mad are you gonna be right now if I try to search for the lyrics? Are you gonna be super pissed? Are some of you guys sitting at... Well, to the guy that lied to me about the lyrics, and from you all, to me for doing this...
You stupid fucking cunt.
I know I am. But look, bro, I want to know what this cat is saying. I know where we are. We're at a minute and 28. I'll even back it up a couple of seconds. How about that? Catch me outside. How about that? Lyrics. No, see, that's the one you lied to me about, you fucker. Do you not have, if you don't have one, just say you don't have one. Alright, whatever. Fuck it. I love that guitar, dude. Ew.
Might be waiting for someone. Might be there for us to see.
I like the hi-hat, too. It's like the one from Sober that Tool used.
Might be there for us to see. Might be staring directly at me.
This one feels kind of sad a little bit, no? Did you like that shit right there? The ending note?
Inside there's a lullaby. Slurred voice of the children cry. On the inside.
See, my guy told Caspar, I don't know, I'm probably saying your name wrong, dude, but he said he was breaking down guitar solos for me, and I'm gonna make this quick, but he was saying that, you know, they're supposed to, like, tell a story and, you know, invoke a feeling, and I feel like with riffs like this, it gives you that same, it's like a piano vibe when they get on that. The really, I'll show you what I'm talking about. See, this song is dangerous, bro. And I tell you why. Because when I'm listening to this, I'm comfortable to just do other shit. So, I'm not bored with it. But it makes me comfortable enough to forget that I'm doing this with you right now. It's almost like I have it playing in the background like I would any other song. Although that guitar right there is a little repetitive. Here we go, here's the shit I like. They got a piano in there too. What are they saying to you right now? To me, this is like I'm walking. It's cold, it's raining. Something fucked up just happened. Trying to walk it off. Memories flashing. Thinking about the past. Maybe a breakup, family member passed away, maybe your dog died. I dare say this is kind of Pink Floyd-ish. I've completely forgotten that I was doing a fucking video, but the ginger thing happened when I was listening to the Cloud Factory. I think that's the song. I know that's the album. I probably had the song wrong. Might be Outlander, something like that. But I put this in the playlist, dude. Don't bullshit. Because, I mean, don't get me wrong, this is not an everyday track. However, when the mood is right, bro, this is the shit to go on. Even a long drive, like, dude, it makes me, all the things that I said before still are true. You know, cold, rainy night, you got shit going on, you're walking through the city or whatever, maybe. Or even you're going down a trail if you live out in a mountain someplace. And you're just looking up, you know, over at the stars. If you're walking through the city when those lights are flashing, you know, I'm picturing like, you know, neon signs for the hotels and shit. And just triggering memories of different things. And it's like a mixed bag of emotions. Kind of sad, maybe a little bit happy in that sort of depressing kind of a way. That's the feel that I get from it. Now, granted, I didn't have the lyrics in front of me, so I don't know exactly what the guy was singing about. But it really, I don't know if the main focus was the instruments, dude. But that's what grabbed me. But I think that's also one of the marks of a good song in this particular case, because the lyrics didn't take from it, but they did add to it. When the focus shifted back over to the vocals, it didn't ruin the experience. And I know if you got, those of you that are real into music, you know exactly what I'm talking about. You know, hate if you want. I don't give a fuck, bro. Most of y'all know what's up, though. You know I'm not talking to you. I mean the people that just come through and assume they know what is going on here. But that's besides the point. It ain't about that.
Are you threatening me?
No. I'm giving you facts, dude. I'm giving you facts, dude. So I like this one. I'm actually moving some content around. So this will come out a little bit earlier. I mean, full disclosure, I already got the next week and a half done. So I got some shit to move around because, you know, Jen's birthday is coming up and I don't want to be in here all day recording videos and shit. I actually want to try to do something with her. But, I mean, that's, you know, for the podcast or not at all. Either way, I'll leave this here. I think I rambled on long enough. Appreciate the suggestions. Welcome to all the new subscribers. If you're not subscribed yet, do that shit if you want to. If you don't, can't force you, buddy. Can't do it. But you should, because there's a good chance I might come across an artist that I'm going to rip to pieces, or I might find some shit that I like that is completely outside of my wheelhouse, dude. Like this right here. Never in a million years would I think I would listen to something like that and actually enjoy it, but here we are. So, you know, it's definitely a process. Interesting. Check out the podcast, rate it, subscribe to it, download it. However it is that you can do it, check it out. Let me know what you think and all that nonsense. Seven episodes out. Eight is going to be on the way. Coming to end of next week. You'll get used to the schedule. But, alright, that's it. Shut up. You're rambling.
Surprise, motherfucker.
You thought it was over. I thought it was over, too, and I forgot about the piano thing I was talking about. And I want to leave y'all hanging. Hit him. Come on, bro. I don't even like this. Full disclosure. You know, she was watching this cartoon and I heard the piano from the other fucking room, bro. And I had to come in and be like, yo, what is that? What is that right there? It's fucking talking to me. I'm like the Son of Sam for pianos.
I put a whole bag of jelly beans up my ass.
One way to get happy.
I can't even.
Dude, I can listen to this whole thing. I won't do it with you here. Just because it'll be boring, but... You know, you see what I'm saying. And I'll add this into the other one. Alright, gotta go do some more shit. I'll catch you later.